Wait for it. Wait for it. Drop it.
Fake dog, no love, you get the slugs. Even for gusto, your luck though. I didn't know till I was drunk though. You freak to lay down, give the aid out. Prostitute turn, got the gate down. 96 ways I made out. Montana way, the good F-E-L-L-A. Verbal AK spray, tip detach it. Jump out the range, empty out the ashtray. The glasses A, make it mad cash. It's clay, red dot plots. Murder schemes, 32 shotguns. Regulate with my thuns, 17 rocks. Gleam for one ring, you let me let y'all know one thing. That's one life, one love, so there can only be one king. The highlights are living. Bring the staff, roll dice and linen.
Love that shit.
On the minimums. 20 G bets, I'm winning.
All right.
Threats, I'm sending them. Lex with TV sets the minimum.
So, down to business here. I'm making this video today because I feel pretty compelled to talk about this. Something I saw in the sky this past weekend. So, I don't know how much you guys have heard about chemtrails, very controversial issue. Once again, doesn't really get much or any exposure in mainstream media, but all different sources of alternative media talk about it quite a bit. But allegedly, in case you didn't know, our government has been spraying the skies with certain highly potent chemicals in an attempt to slow global warming. So, there you have it. Once again, classic problem-reaction-solution by the government. They create a problem, that being global warming, which hundreds of scientists say is a farce, and that the Earth is actually cooling. You know, but global warming is just another excuse for them to come in and kill off 80% of the world's population. So, and that and tax every single facet of our lives until we're in complete poverty, just like in the times of the first American Revolution. So, but anyway, back on track. What I want to talk about was what I saw this past weekend. Very peculiar. So, here it goes. So, me and a buddy of mine, we were chilling out, drinking a couple brews. And we took a walk up to this pond that's like 10 minutes walking distance from his house, probably. And just when we were walking there, I noticed, I don't know, maybe like two or three planes in the 10 minutes that we were walking this pond in his neighborhood. So, you know, got his attention, and he looked up, and I mentioned the chemtrail theory or reality, whatever, what have you. I mentioned it to my buddy, and, you know, of course, he's never heard anything about it before, and he didn't fucking believe a word I said. He's just like, well, that's, you know, that sounds a little too far out that our government would actually be spraying us with highly toxic chemicals. I haven't done much research myself. I don't know what kind of chemicals they're spraying, but. So we get to the beach, and hold on one second here. So we get to the beach, and already we saw like two or three planes when on our way up. So we get to the beach, and you know, we're there, I don't know, maybe no more than half an hour. And within the 30 minutes that we're there, I think we spotted probably anywhere between 8 to 12 planes. The exact kind of planes that we saw on the walk up. They were completely silent. They didn't make any noise. And they left some kind of trail of white smog, smoke, whatever. I don't even know. And so he, like, my buddy and me, we were both, after when we were leaving the beach, we were kind of like, all right, that was weird. You know, we saw 8 or 9 all the same kinds of planes leaving behind some kind of smoke. And you know, he had never even heard of chemtrails before, and now he was like, yeah, that was weird, man. I don't know what to make of that. So we're walking back to his house. And we're turning onto the street that he lives off of. And basically this street, it's like a big downhill, and it's flat for a little bit, and then that's where his road is, and then there's another big uphill. So the street's based shaped like a big half pipe or whatever. So we're walking, and we get to the very top of the hill, the downhill. And we just see as far as because you have a pretty good vantage point. You get to the top of this hill and you can see, you know, off into the sky. And we probably saw, I don't know, like 9 or 10 planes. 9 or 10 planes, you know, miles down the skyline, all lined up in synchronicity. Same exact planes that we saw from before. But there, we saw like 9 or 10 of them all the way down the skyline, all leaving this smog. So obviously, there's no other plausible explanation for what we saw besides they were combing a large area with some type of smog. I don't know if it was chemtrails. I guess there's something else called contrails, which I don't know what it is. I probably should have looked it up before I made this video, but apparently there's contrails and then chemtrails. Like I said, I don't know much about it. I haven't done much research on it. So if anybody else has any information or any videos or whatever, anything, definitely hit me up, because after I saw this, I'm definitely more interested in this subject. I mean, I never really doubted that it was true. When I first heard about it, I was like, yeah, nothing really surprises me these days when it comes to what our government's doing. So, you know, it just, you know, they put chemicals in all our food and all our, you know, milk and everything. So, why else, you know, they taint all our vaccines and sell them to foreign countries when they get caught. I don't know if anybody heard about the drug company Bayer. Apparently sent out the AIDS virus. Somehow the AIDS virus got into their vaccines, which in the first place, that's just fucking weird. I don't know how if they have a huge vat of the fucking AIDS in their factory and they're just, oh shit, the AIDS fell into the vat. You know, we can't afford to lose profits. You know, we got to make the monthly quota, so hopefully no one will notice. I mean, that's fucking crazy. And so they get caught. They get caught in America. Few people take all the heat. You know, not even the real higher-ups. Just, few people get thrown under the bus. So what do? They take all the vaccines, and since they didn't want to lose any money, they shipped them all out to Spain, France, and Japan. These tainted vaccines with the AIDS virus sent them out to France, Spain, and Japan. Knowingly, after they had got caught in America, they sold them to cheap, probably all poor third world parts of each respective country. I mean, it's but anyway, I'm getting off topic here. So like I was saying, if anybody has any information about the chemtrails or anything, fucking hit me up. I definitely want to learn more about it. So y'all keep it real, live well, be good. Peace.